We'll see if it ends up working out. Hopefully it does. And this hand is, just like game one, except we have the island. So I don't think we're gonna mulligan. We can go ahead and start off. I don't know, it's a young wolf. Start off with our Abyssinian Priest. Hope maybe we draw a Spectral Rider this turn. Young Wolf is fine, actually. It's it, a little on the ineffective side at times, but when he's got stuff like Hunger of the Hell Pack to worry about, and he's an aggro deck, it's not the worst, I suppose. Yeah, great. Another Plains. Just what we want. So I don't think I really have time to get Faith Shield going, so I'm just going to go ahead and block this wolf. I mean, yeah, that is pretty bad though. If he does have Hunger of the Help Pack, but wait, no, we're. I don't think he does, because he would have gone to attack immediately, and so I'm just gonna slam blockers right there on the young wolf if he goes to attack. And the next turn play Seraph Cultist. Yeah, it looks like an Urdwall Ripper. Well, there's that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and put this priest on the back burner for now. Block his young wolf, and then let's see, take four, or I could block his Ripper, then play Seraph Cultist, and just resign to the fact that we'll end up losing a priest. What's going to happen alternatively is we block the young wolf, take four. This is a 3/2. Play the occultist. He attacks with the Urdwall Ripper again, and but our occultist can block his Torch Fiend, and so then the Ripper becomes a 4/3. So our priest is stuck tapping that until we either draw Smite the Monstrous. So I'm actually fine just trading here. So we'll let that happen and take three. And now we can play a Seraph Occultist. Mote his team, play Delver next turn, play and Spectral Rider or another, our second Abyssinian Priest and Hath Faith Shield. We'll just have to see what we've got going on here. Okay, so we're going to combat, and we've got. And attack with everything you say. Well, what does this mean? This could mean he's got a Festerhide Boar. That would be unfortunate. Or he's got a something else. I'm gonna go ahead and block this and pass, I think. And if he has Festerhide Boar, he's got a Festerhide Boar. I'll just draw Smite the Monstrous. And he looks like he's got a Geist Flame. That is not as nearly as good. However, it does make Delver of Secrets a lot worse. We're gonna go ahead and mill ourselves because, geez, we've got some scabs in our deck, and he's got cards like Geist Flame and Wild Hunger, which, surprising to say, I don't really want him to have access to. Unfortunately, the only flashback spell we have at the moment is Lingering Souls, which we cannot flashback at the moment. And if he does have a Geist Flame for our Delver, and at that point I think wasting a Faith Shield on it is going to be okay, since we've got no other action, and barring our draw step changing that, it's going to probably lead to a more of a win than having this Faith Shield stuck as, being able to randomly Mize a flip with Delver, since we've got five other cards left until we see what we mill, actually. All right, we're finally ready to mill. He debated and debated. We milled an island. So that was like we drew a card. And a Scab Goliath, which is kind of awkward. I would rather have drawn that, I suppose. Well, here it goes. Oh no, Plains is not what I want to draw. So, not only do we not have double blue mana jar to play our double blue spell, we have a bunch of Plains and a Faith Shield, and that's about it. So, I don't like the position that we're in. Granted, we're not under too much pressure. I would much rather have had this bad boy in my hand than this nice little piece. But that's the way things go, folks. So we're gonna go ahead and take this one and see what kind of follow-up our opponent has. Nothing, you say. All right. Do we want to reveal this card? Nope. So we're gonna go ahead and hold this guy back, I think, because he could have Ambush Viper. And I feel like preserving our life total is going to be better than taking two. So I'm gonna play that and pass the turn. And he's got three cards in his hand. I think, yeah, that's interesting. I could just not do that. I would rather play around Ambush Viper. I'd really want to trade this Delver off because we don't really have too many. And he didn't have it. Okay, well, maybe I was just being paranoid. I am definitely going to block Young Wolf this time because that will give him an incentive to. Well, let's see. I mean, that'll make his guy a 2-2, and then he can hit for two more, so he's on the 7 turn clock, the 14 turn clock, and I suppose I don't actually have to block until I draw a bigger creature. I think I'm going to not block, actually. This is a slightly odd line, I suppose. Let's see what we've got. Fling! Okay, well, his guy comes back, and I don't think I really care about the Delver, so I'm gonna go ahead and let that die because he's got Geist Flame. So I'd rather have the Face Shield. And there's the other land. Yes, awesome. Yeah, I think I'm gonna use Faith Shield on his Young Wolf. I'm gonna go ahead and block that. And that was interesting. And he has the Ambush Viper. Gosh, I just knew everything. So now I'm just gonna block the Ambush Viper. That's a lot better. Then hopefully I draw a creature at some point, so I can just block this stupid 2-2 that does nothing. But yeah, so. Pro green, come on. And we've got a 6-turn clock on our head. Let's see if he's got any follow-up. A Festerhide Boar, lovely. Okay. Well, yeah, okay, that was fair. Gonna go ahead and smite that now, because he doesn't have Hunger of the Howlpack in his hand. And I think at this point, I don't really want to trade my Spectral Rider for his Young Wolf, so I'm gonna go ahead and attack. Because we have a lot more, we have more creatures in our deck that actually cold this guy. So he drew a land. He's got a land in his hand, I'm fairly certain. Man, Skagblithe would just be insane here. Insanely large and awesome and taking over everything. But it's in our graveyard, and I'm very sad because of that. Looks like we have a Hunger of the Howlpack, or Wild Hunger, rather. All right, so we're in a little bit of a situation now. He's got a lot of damage on our end. Ooh, this is good. So this is going to end up working out pretty well for us. Ideally, he goes to flash it back, his Wild Hunger, that is. Because we're going to block and we have Skillful Lunge, which gives first strike and plus 2 plus 0, if you did not notice that. And get Staff Shepherd. That is going to be problematic. Because that guy's going to flip, and so we're going to be in a little bit of trouble here. Now, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to attack with the Spectral Rider and then. If he attacks with everything, I'll block the Shepherd and with the Geist and then use Skillful Lunge. Because I think if I leave both creatures back, he's less likely to attack and is just going to pass and flip his guy. But I want him to attack, so I'm going to go ahead and not play or only leave the Chopper Geist back. All right, here's to hoping. No. Okay. So that was how our. Ooh, let's see. And I think what I'm going to do now is. I think what I'm going to do here, folks, is. I'm going to play Priest and then Skillful Lunge my guy. But I can't really attack with anything because he can attack with both. I mean, this is going to flip the Howler. I need to flip the Howler, otherwise, he just plays Wild Hunger and then kills me. What I'm going to do is. Play the priest, skillful lunge, pass the turn. Because if he attacks, if I attack with something and he, if he, then he's gonna attack with both, and he's got he'll wild hunger whatever the spectral rider blocks, and then he'll have. I have to block the other one. Because if I don't, he just wild hungers. I take three trample and two from the other guy, and he's got geist in his yard. So it's not the position that I want to be in. So we're gonna go ahead and hopefully draw something really good, and then this priest can keep his howler at bay. And then yeah, we're just basically in top deck mode. Because the priest is gonna trade off with the shepherd, and then we're just basically trading the top of our deck with each other. Yeah, he drew Crosshave Empire. That is unfortunate. So, what's going to happen is he's going to attack with both and then play Wild Hunger, flashing it back. Oh no. Oh, wait, what is this? Oh, darn, he saw it. Let's see. Well, we can't gain any life in our deck, so we have to block one each. And yep, so I'm gonna go ahead and block here and block there. And yeah, everything's just gonna be mighty peachy. Because I don't think there's much we can draw that is going to save us. Yep, Wild Hunger, he saw it. So we end up taking three. None of his guys die. Both of our guys die. And yep, that's about it. So, another crushing defeat. Why did he have to draw so many spells? Okay. So I'm just going to die when he attacks with Gadstaff Shepherd. So, yep. All right. See you later, folks.